Hi guys, welcome back to this week's My Weekly Rage Fix. This week's parsha is Parshas Miketz. Today is also Hanukkah, so we will speak a little bit about that. So I just want to first wish everybody a happy Hanukkah, a lichting Hanukkah. I also want to dedicate this week's My Weekly Rage Fix to our good friend Nick Stiglitz, Nisano Ben, Carolyn. Hopefully he will have a complete recovery and become a leader amongst the Jewish people. So in this week's parsha, we continue the story with Joseph. He becomes viceroy over the entire land of Egypt. There's a hunger. And Yaakov Avinu, sends down his sons to Egypt in order for them to bring back grain. They should have what to eat. So the brothers come down. They finally meet with Joseph, not realizing, of course, who he was. And he sends them back with grain. Now, they had paid for their grain, and he told his son that he should sneakily put their money back into their sacks, which they had their grain in as well. And a lot of weird things had been going on with the brothers, with their entire coming down, how Joseph was talking to them, and he seemed to know a lot of things about them, and Joseph kept getting the upper hand on them, and they exclaim, interestingly, when they open up their bags, when one of them wanted to stop and feed his donkey, he noticed that the money that he had paid for was put back into his bag. And they exclaim, "Ma zos asa lekimanu? What is this that Hashem has done to us?" Now, they understood that something weird was going on. Joseph's maybe plotting against them, and they understood that it was really from Hashem, that Hashem was running the scenes, and Joseph was only Hashem's emissary. And there was some type of plot that the brothers wanted to know. Why? Why is this happening? What is going on in this entire story? And the brothers understood that it's probably something that they had done wrong. And I want to sneak or jump into Hanukkah a second over here. There is an opinion that when we start to light the menorah, we all know that we follow the opinion that says that the first night we light one candle, the second light two candles, and so on and so forth. Yet there's another opinion that says, no, the first night we start out with eight, the second night we do seven, third night six, and so on and so forth. You minimize in the amount of candles that are burned. And the question is why? And the lesson that Beis Shammai, who is the one that holds of that theory, of that view, is that we're all wowed by big, massive miracles. It's wowing. Yet, we all know that everything in nature is really up to Hashem, and we are guilty of not recognizing Hashem in these small things. The fact that oil even burns is miraculous. You know, if water were to burn, it would be normal to us as well. Hydrogen, you have oxygen. Perfect, they're two flammable gases, so you put them together, they burn. But oil, who should say oil should burn? So there's really no greater miracle that oil burns than water burns. For us, it's just natural, so we don't take it to be wowing. But we always have to realize that everything that Hashem does is miraculous. And everything in nature is incredibly miraculous. From the tiniest DNA in the smallest part of the ant's leg, the fact that the cells there work is miraculous, and we have to think about that. And that is why the first night eight, the second night seven, the second night, third night six, because even when you get down to the last few nights, two, one, the small fact that even the first night there was oil was also miraculous. And it's our job to recognize even the small things. And the brothers had exclaimed, "Ma zos asa lekimanu? What is this that God had done to us?" Meaning they were trying to understand the small picture as well. There's something going on, and it seemed all chaotic to them. Now, Joseph knew everything, and they were trying to figure it out. They were trying to, what is this? There's something going on here that we are not able to recognize. They were trying to put their finger on what it was. And that onus is upon us. And it's yet another obligation of the miracle of the holiday of Hanukkah that we should think about, contemplate. And by the way, if we do contemplate it, that's when we'll have siyata d'shmaya. We will have heavenly assistance in everything that what we do. And if we do realize the small little details in our lives, how much happier lives will be. Have a illuminated Hanukkah and a happy one. I will talk to you next week. Shabbos. Bye.